She's a woman of a certain age now, 33, which by the standards of elite tennis is ancient. Yes, Serena Williams is slowing down. After losing the first set 6-love to Flavia Panetta earlier this month at the Hopman Cup, she ordered an on-court espresso. Properly caffeinated, Williams dropped only 3 games in the last 2 sets to win easily. But it must be said, her dominance of recent years has softened into, well, occasional lapses of good play. She won 7 titles last year, including the U.S. Open, and the check, which included a $1 million bonus for winning the U.S. Open series, was for $4 million, a record for either gender. It was her 18th Grand Slam singles title, tying her with legends Martina Navratilova and Chris Evert.
I was so young, and to go from that, you know, right, having nothing and to having, you know, 18 titles from, you know, all the hard work I did is really an humbling, unbelievable experience.
It seems fairly obvious. Serena probably will break that tie this year and collect her 19th major. But at this late date, can she find the consistency that marked her best years? Last season, she lost in the 4th round of the Australian Open, the 2nd at Roland Garros, and the 3rd round at Wimbledon.
I tried at Australia, it didn't happen, and then I tried it again, and I kept trying, and it wasn't really working out for me. And so, when my moment I least expected it, I was just like, okay, let's just not try, let's just play tennis.
With the WTA's fleet of oncoming young stars, she's going to have to do more than just call for coffee to hold her place at the top. The milestone that matters? Steffi Graf's open-era record of 22 Grand Slam singles titles. Does Serena have it in her? 2015 will give us a good idea, starting with the season's first major, the Australian Open.